This is probably my 16th Syracuse welcome. I've been at the university 20 years, so this is definitely a unique experience, but we're doing our best to make the students feel welcome under these unique circumstances. As you can see, we have our banner behind us. Welcome to the Orange family.
Just under 400 first-year students moved into their dorms on August 2nd. These students are from the states and territories on the New York Travel Advisory List. It means they have to quarantine for 14 days, and they're doing it on campus. The price tag? $1,000. And new rules meant getting cleared for potential health risks before they could go to their dorm buildings.
They're getting checked to make sure that we have their test results. Students are going to need to have a negative COVID test.
Students will need to practice social distancing during the two-week quarantine. Freshman Marco Savitsky drove up from Florida with his father. Even with the restrictions in place, he's still looking forward to his first year on campus.
Again, I'm happy that Syracuse University is taking the precautions to have this opportunity for students from the hot states.
And Marco's not the only optimistic freshman.
Really, you know, if Syracuse is offering a college experience this year, no matter what it looks like, I'm gonna take it.
He's taking it, but Foss isn't certain he'll spend his entire first semester on campus.
I think ultimately it's up to the students though to make the right choice so we can stay on campus this fall.
Freshmen could only have one person help them move in. So after a long drive, Rick Fritz waited outside while his wife helped his son move in.
I guess I'm giving Mama Bear, giving her everything, and she's running the show.
Fritz says that he likes how SU is handling bringing students back to campus during a pandemic.
Being someone that's a healthcare professional, I've been beyond impressed.
It's been his son's lifelong dream to attend SU. As a parent, Fritz knows this is the right step for his son.
As long as he's happy, then I'm happy.
But as a healthcare professional, he's still uncertain about the semester.
It's a crapshoot, to be honest with you. I mean, things are constantly changing daily, hourly, so you just don't know. The hope, I like to think of any place, this place, in Syracuse, and anywhere in the state of New York, will be better off than everyone else, but you just don't know.
Returning students from hot states will arrive later this month. Reporting for Citrus TV News, I'm Erin Lyons.